Hello, I'm Congresswoman Yvette D. Clarke of the 9th District of New York. I serve right here in the House of Representatives on the Energy and Commerce Committee, the Small Business Committee, and I chair the caucus on Black Women and Girls alongside Congresswoman Bonnie Watson Coleman and Congresswoman Robin Kelly. I also serve as co-chair for the Caribbean Caucus, which is co-chaired by Congresswoman Plaskett and Congresswoman Maxine Waters. I am also co-chair of the Multicultural Media Caucus, co-chaired by Congressman Tony Hawkins and Congresswoman Judy Chip. I'm standing here in the halls of Congress in front of the portrait of the Honorable Shirley Chisholm, who was one of my predecessors and the first Black woman to be elected in the United States House of Representatives. I thought it was very important to start a multicultural media caucus here in the United States House of Representatives because too often the contributions in media, technology, and telecom of people of color go so unrecognized and so unrewarded. It was important that we used a platform right here in Congress to raise up their valuable contributions and advocate for continued inclusion in the world of media.
What we've often found is that the contributions of people of color have been imitated on television, in radio, and many of our talents have been appropriated by others, and they have been given all of the glory and all of their recognition and accolades based upon the authentic experiences of people of color. And I really think that it's time, particularly in the 21st century, that we do away with that. Because we know we have the content providers, we have the individuals who already have the talent, the skill, the expertise to present to the world what it is like to tell our own stories. It is my pleasure to bring to South by Southwest a panel that will have a conversation about this very timely and important topic, cultural appropriation. And I know that there are many people across this nation who have an interest in this subject matter. It's being raised on multiple platforms, whether it's on our Twitter feeds, on our Facebook pages, or even in front of the Oscars. We are calling for people to come to listen, to hear, and to contribute to this dialogue that I know will be liberating for so many content providers, for so many technicians and individuals who have seen this phenomena continue to grow, but are pushing back so that we can get an authentic view to who we are as a nation. And the South by Southwest Festival has become the premier venue for those who want to showcase their new talents, their technology, and we believe that it is important that we have a presence there because we know that we can help shape the conversation in a new and dynamic way.
There was a movie called 10 with an actress called Bo Derek, and she decided that she would wear her hair in braids, and she was seen as a fashion icon. Fast forward to today, on today's runways, all throughout Europe and the United States, we see models not of African descent wearing same braids. And now fast forward to the U.S. military, where women are actually being banned from wearing their hair, Black women in particular, in the braids. So how is it acceptable once appropriated by a woman of European descent? Yet, it becomes an issue of controversy when women in the military are wearing their hair as they've done naturally for generations. This is why it's so very important that we have this conversation. Like Jesse Williams at the 2016 BET Awards, there are a whole host of celebrities, social media activists, and academics who can actually speak to this subject matter, and I know we're going to perform an outstanding panel. So click the link below to vote for our panel, which is going to be fabulous.